Can you purchase a property and because of that immigrate to Canada? Before I answer that question, please subscribe to our channel and enable notifications. The first question is, what is a property? When I'm talking about property, I'm talking about purchasing an apartment unit in one of Canada's large cities, or maybe a ranch, or maybe a farm, or a detached home in one of the cities of Canada or one of the suburban areas of Canada, an industrial land, etc., etc. Generally speaking, we're focusing on real estate purchases. Can people from outside Canada purchase real estate in Canada? The simple answer to this question is yes. Unless the government is worried about money laundering or terrorist activities, or the kind of property you're purchasing somehow is related to the national security or sensitivities, then you are good to go. You can basically go to any city in Canada and purchase a land. Keep that in mind that some cities of Canada are the most wanted cities in terms of real estate purchase. Those cities include Vancouver or the Greater Vancouver area and Toronto or the Greater Toronto area. If you decide to purchase a property in Vancouver or Toronto and some surrounding areas of these two cities, then you will end up paying 15% extra in taxes. For example, if the purchase price of the property is $1 million and you are not a permanent resident of Canada or a citizen of Canada and you purchase that property, then you need to pay $150,000 extra in taxes. This does not apply to other cities of Canada. So if you purchase something in Ottawa, which is the capital of Canada, you don't pay that, or in Niagara Falls, or in some other cities like Montreal, in Calgary, Edmonton, we don't have these taxes. But in Toronto and Vancouver and some surrounding areas of Toronto and Vancouver, you have to pay that 15% extra. Can you get it back? Yes, if within certain number of years you become a permanent resident of Canada, you can get that 15% back. But imagine that you fail to become a permanent resident of Canada. It's up to you. If you still want to purchase a property in one of those cities, good for you. Can you get a mortgage or loan for purchasing your property in Canada? Generally speaking, mortgages are available to foreign nationals. If you are a US citizen and you can verify your income, then you may end up receiving up to 80% mortgage. That's amazing. For other people from other countries, they may receive usually up to 65% in mortgages. But if you fail to verify your income, then you usually need to pay at least 50% down. Look into that matter before committing to purchasing a property in Canada. It is in your best interest that you get in touch with a professional mortgage broker in Canada and ask them these questions. I'm not a mortgage broker, I'm an immigration consultant, and what I say is based on just Googling the internet and finding these answers. Of course, the big question is that can you immigrate to Canada by purchasing a property in Canada? Unfortunately, the simple answer is no. You may not simply purchase a property in Canada and immigrate to Canada. We don't currently have any federal immigration options or provincial immigration options that involve purchasing a property in Canada, or they are based on purchasing a property in Canada. Before you get too disappointed, let me tell you that purchasing a property in Canada in some cases could actually help you. An example would be immigration under humanitarian and compassionate considerations. I have another video about this. I will post the link up here. If you are applying under HNC inside Canada, one of the parameters that the immigration officers will consider in terms of approving your application is your establishment and ties to Canada. And obviously, owning a property in Canada is a reflection of you being established in Canada. Another example that purchasing a property could help is when you are immigrating under PNP, or you are targeting a specific province of Canada. If you purchase a property in that province, that is a convincing factor to show that your intention is truly to stay in that province and your intention is not to leave the province. I have a video about PNP immigration and leaving the province. I will post the link up here. You can watch that one as well. Purchasing property will not guarantee your success under HNC or humanitarian applications or under PNP. That's why you also need to think about complications. What if you apply for immigration, you purchase a property in Canada, and your application gets refused? What can you do about your property? So if you are going to purchase a property in Canada, I think it is in your best interest that you purely think about investment in Canada. Now, if that investment helps you with your immigration application, good for you. If it doesn't, then maybe you need to think of other factors to enhance your immigration application. Thank you very much for watching this video. My name is Al Parsai. I'm a regulated Canadian immigration consultant. I teach immigration consulting at Ashton College. I'm the bestseller author of the book, 88 Tips on Immigration to Canada. You can find out about your purchasing options by visiting 88tips.ca. Please like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to our channel, and enable notifications. See you soon.